Hi everyone. Today we're going to talk a little bit about something that we call the fundamental attribution error. This has to do with the way that we make judgments, both about other people's behavior and even about our own behavior. The most common example used to demonstrate the attribution error is when someone slips and falls, like on a banana peel. You know the situation. Banana peel rests on the sidewalk, pedestrian comes by, the rest is history. If you're watching this happen, you'll most likely think that this person is clumsy, clueless, or just bad at walking. But what happens when you slip and fall? Well, most likely, you will blame the banana peel itself, or whoever carelessly left it there. In a similar but different situation, you may blame an uneven sidewalk. See, the fundamental attribution error is the tendency to overestimate dispositional or internal influences and underestimate situational factors when observing someone else's actions, and doing the exact opposite when observing our own. This happens to all of us every day. Let's look at another example. Here's me. I'm trying to get to work in the morning, but my car won't start. I get out, I open the hood, and I start looking for the problem. Of course, I make sure that I first check the battery, but the battery seems to be working just fine. As I continue working, a neighbor walks by, and she suggests kindly that I check the battery. I explain that I have, and it's not the problem. A few minutes later, another person comes by and offers the same advice. I've already tried that, so again, I explain that that's not the problem. This continues for a while. Several neighbors come by over the next half hour as I work on my car, each one offering the same advice: check the battery. This is getting frustrating to me. Finally, this kid comes by and asks if I've checked the battery. My frustration boils over and I shout at him, telling him that it's not the battery and I know how to fix my car, and I don't need him telling me what to do. He doesn't know that I've been trying to fix my car for 30 minutes, and he doesn't know that he's the seventh person to suggest that I check the battery. All he thinks is that I'm a jerk. But how about you try this? Let's watch this video from Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, and see what you think.
Well, as long as you're feeling good and you know the rules and the lifelines and you're ready to play, we're going to play. Are you ready?
Ready.
Okay, then let's play. Buy surge protectors to protect their possessions from unexpected surges of what? Electric current, water flow, air pressure, buyer's remorse.
I will say B, water flow, final answer. Wait.
Oh, Chase, it's electric current. Oh, Chase, I'm so sorry. Ah, darn.
Pretty stupid, right? Well, maybe. Let's rewind a little bit and learn a little bit more about Chase's situation.
And joining me now is Chase Sampson, a college junior in Nashville, Tennessee. And I understand, Chase, that you flew in last night. You didn't get here till 3 in the morning, and you haven't slept a wink, huh?
No, I pretty much have coffee flowing through my veins right now.
Do you really? Yeah. But as a college student, I'm thinking maybe that's not so rare.
Yeah, I'm up pretty late, mostly. I'm kind of insomniac, I guess.
Okay, but you know where you are.
I'm feeling good.
All right, good.
Well, maybe he's not just a dunce, and maybe it's not so easy to judge. Think about it.